Welcome to HWA Wrestling. I'm Les Thatcher along with Jim Cornette. And today's program will be a memorial show. I normally don't read prepared statements, but I feel because to keep my composure, I must do that today. I want to tell you on the morning of December the 15th, one of the HWA and pro wrestling's brightest stars left us. He passed away in his sleep, the victim of an apparent heart attack. Russ Haas, age 27. Has been taken from his mother and his father, his brother Charlie, and his wife Deidre. And Russ was laid to rest in Houston, Texas on December the 19th. I feel so fortunate to have had the opportunity to get to know Russ and the chance to have coached him. After suffering a heart attack back in September, Russ has been going through therapy and had been cleared by the doctors to return to his training for his professional wrestling career after the first of the year. Russ Haas was not only a fine young athlete, but a gentleman and a friend to all of us that knew him. And his sense of humor was always there, no matter what. My last contact with Russ came at an HWA event on the night before he left us. And he came to me in the dressing room, hugged me, and said, Les, this is driving me crazy. I can't wait to get back to work. Russ will always have a place in my training sessions. And throughout this show, you will see comments made by some of Russ's friends and fellow wrestlers in the memory of him. This show will be dedicated to Russ Haas. Let's have now a 10-bell salute. Now, a videotape of the Haas Brothers in action. Absolutely, the Haas Brothers, Russ and Charlie. Russ, the one with the goatee, Charlie, the clean-shaven of the Haas Brothers out of Edmond, Oklahoma. And, of course, a lot of great wrestling talent coming out of Oklahoma. The Briscoe Brothers, Bill Watts, Danny Hodge.
And more, the referee calls for the bell, and we've got action right now. The Haas Brothers against Johnny the Bull and Reno. And right now, that is Johnny the Bull.
Reno,
opening up. I knew you'd catch me, Les. Reno, opening up with Charlie Haas, and there's move and counter move there. And Les, you've got to be impressed with these Haas brothers. They were tremendous amateurs in college, tremendous athletic backgrounds on both these young men, and you can't come any higher recommendation
than
Gerald Briscoe, the brother of former NWA World Champion Jack Briscoe, personally selected these kids to be signed by the WWF to a developmental contract and sent to HWA. Wait a minute, there was a pinning combination.
Yes, nice try for the roll-up by Russ Haas. As he goes back to that arm on Reno. Reno on defense now as Russ windmills that arm, applying the pressure. And of course, the Haas brothers you mentioned, Jimmy, are one of the top teams in the HWA.
Oh, wait a minute, look at this.
Tag.
The Haas brothers, double team maneuver. Boomerang into a belly-to-belly overhead.
Beautiful.
Down.
Gonna try for the pin. Two count by Ray Ramsey, but Reno kicks out. Great teamwork by the Haas brothers. Not only brothers, but a well-oiled machine. As you mentioned, great amateur wrestlers out of Seton Hall University.
Oh, wait a minute. Did you see that? Johnny the Bull shot the knee into the back, and now Charlie Haas responds in kind, but he took his eye off the ball, Les.
Yes, he did. Once he took his eyes off of Reno, the WCW combination is in the driver's seat. Reno working on Charlie Haas now. He goes for the arm and tags Johnny the Bull.
First time we're going to see Johnny the Bull in legitimate legal action here. Now double elbow to the gut. And now a kick right to the side of the head and an uppercut punch takes Charlie Haas down to the mat.
And both combinations working well as a team.
Oh, wait a minute. Jim. Johnny the Bull hooking that leg, but referee Ray Ramsey was out of position. And Les, of course, we touched on it earlier in the program. Both Ohio Valley Wrestling, located in Louisville. I am the matchmaker for OVW and the Heartland Wrestling Association, of course, right here in the great Buckeye state of Ohio.
That's
bringing some of the future superstars of professional wrestling to the fans through the developmental program with the WWF. But now this WCW invasion, what if it's spinebuster, lateral press and no.
And Johnny the Bull tries to bend. We, right at this point, too, would like to welcome WRGT-TV, Fox Channel 45 in Dayton, Ohio, We're on their station every Saturday night beginning at 12 midnight. We hope you'll join us. We want to welcome them aboard. Right now, it's the Haas brothers on defense as Charlie needs to make that tag to Brother Russ.
Well, Reno makes that tag from Johnny the Bull. Now Reno's stepping back in and Charlie Haas in no man's land. Reno and Johnny the Bull, part of this WCW invasion that's trying to take over the HWA. The WCW forces don't want the HWA talent and the WWF developmental talent to make it to the main stage, to Monday Night Raw before they do. Look at the power there.
Beautiful.
My God, that was Steiner-like, and its execution is now. Reno took Charlie Haas over that belly-to-belly suplex and now makes the tag. Johnny the Bull back in, and the Bull and Reno making quick and precise tags while Charlie Haas has been cut off from his brother and his partner for the last several minutes.
And we are seeing a very equal, well-balanced tag team match here. Both teams working well together. The Haas brothers open on offense.
Oh, wait a minute.
Does he have him tag
Haas,
made?
But there was the tag. There was the tag. Charlie Haas made an opening. Charlie Haas overbalanced out of that press slam. Went for the sunset flip. But, oh, no. Come on. Now Reno, while the referee's back is turned, Ray Ramsey distracted by the other Haas boy, Russ Haas, trying to come in and take up for his brother. But that just gives Reno and Johnny the Bull license to kill.
Reno and Bull doubling up as Ray Ramsey is trying to keep Russ Haas out of the ring. Charlie definitely needs to make that tag now. Look at Reno dropping to the knee, shooting those jabs into the midsection, looping the hands into the side of the head with the kicks now. And Reno opening up on offense. And I think Bull and Reno smelling a victory here, Jim.
Wait a minute. There was a dot. Look out now. Oh, there's a T-bone. T-bone suplex. Charlie Haas had just suplexed Reno right out of his boots, and both men are down. But Charlie Haas has had a lot taken out of him over the last several minutes. He's fatigued. The punishment has taken its toll. Is Charlie Haas too disoriented to make the tag to his brother? Or can Reno possibly stop? Oh, wait a minute, there's a
diamond. There's the tag, yes. Russ Haas, the fresh man, and Johnny the Bull, and Russ ducks under the on-charging Johnny the Bull, catches him with a right hand and another right hand. Here comes Reno back into the fray, and Russ drops him. Russ Haas, a man on fire in there, trying to gain that offense back for the team of the Haas brothers. Arm whips, Reno cross ring, takes him high for the backdrop.
Russ Haas has really created an opening here. Russ Haas changed the momentum of this match, but oh no! And Johnny the Bull just grabbed him by the hair and drove him down by the back of the head. Now Johnny the Bull has Russ Haas backed up against the far wall. Charlie Haas still in the ring, so is Reno. Oh, wait a minute. Reno stood up under his man, but Haas held on.
Beautiful Haas balance.
Oh, he snapped his neck on the top rope, and now this thing is broken down into a four-way situation.
And Charlie Haas in now with Johnny the Bull. Let's see Russ up on the apron. Look at here as Charlie slingshots Russ in over the top, drops the Bull. Reno on the floor. Let's see what's going to happen here as the Haas brothers set it up.
What in good gracious! Oh. Backflip, leg drop, cover.
There you have it.
That's it.
Beautifully done.
The winners, Charlie and Russ Haas, in our opening contest here on Heartland Wrestling Association. Les, what a tremendous, tremendous matchup.
What up?
I didn't know Russ for a real long time. I've known him for maybe about a year now. And one thing that I knew with Russ was he was a big-time dog lover. He had a little pit bull and a little Rottweiler, and myself, I'm a big-time dog lover, so we got along in that essence. And one thing I can say about Russ is he was a very laid-back guy. He loved this business more than anything in the world, and it was something that that we're going to miss. He was an athlete, to say the least. This guy could do things in the ring that most of us can only dream of doing. Russ, we'll miss you. God bless you.
No, I really don't have a whole lot to say about this, but for the last 3 months or so, 2 months, I've been Charlie's partner. I've stood in for Russ, and every time me and Charlie went out to the match and we had a match, after it was over, Russ would sit down with us and tell us what we did right, and he'd tell us what we did wrong. And I'm going to be grateful to Russ for a long time, because in the long run, he's going to make me and Charlie a much better wrestler. So thanks, Russ, and God bless.
We're back and ready to roll in the ring right now. The Human Time Bomb, HTV, ready to go against Tony Hawk. And let's go to Hawk for the introduction.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a singles match. Introducing first, from Defiance, Pennsylvania, the Human Time Bomb, HTV. And his opponent.
Well, Les, I tell you, I think HTV needs to cut down on the caffeine somewhat.
Yeah.
He is ticking and he is ready to go, but we heard just a few moments ago the comments from Cody Hawk concerning the situation with Russ Haas. Cody Hawk will now see a different form of action. That's in the ring, and Haas.
Killing no from Malibu Beach, California, he is the surfer, Cody Hawk.
All right, Cody Hawk out against Time Bomb, and of course, as Jim said, you just heard Cody's comments about Russ Haas, and we all, you know, obviously, you know, are very saddened by his loss. Cody had wrestled as partners with Charlie, and right now in singles action, he's got a tough little sucker who's as wide as he is tall, but that makes him a little tougher to handle, Jim.
Well, an unorthodox physique on the Human Time Bomb, but like I said, he's a bundle of energy. And if effort counts for anything, then he should go far in this business. But right now, jockeying for position. Wait a minute. Time Bomb just dumped Cody Hawk right over the top rope, and Hawk landed on the apron, and thank goodness for that.
Yes. Double reverse on the hip lock, and then a slingshot with Cody's throat across that top rope. And HTB is trying to get a pin and trying to get it quick here, Jim.
Boy, I wish I'd have had his energy when I was half my age. Unless the combination of the Ohio Valley weather and laryngitis, I may lose my voice tonight. And a lot of people would say that's a good thing.
I'd say it's a bad thing.
I'm going to try to hang with you as long as I can. Wait a minute. Lateral press, the Time Bomb hooking him up, but he couldn't make it score.
Gets a two count, and Cody Hawk kicks out. Time Bomb, though, opened up strong with offense. He shoots those flippers, those forearms in there. Nice little snap suplex. Let's see if Bomb's going for the cover again. No, Cody rolls up to his force, comes to his feet. Time Bomb clubs him down across the back of the head, shoots him in, trying for the backdrop.
Whoa.
But yes, up and over by Cody, rolls through. Double.
Whoa, wait a minute.
Wow, both of them going for it, and apparently butted heads, Jim.
Little malfunction. And both those guys trying to counter and counter again to the point where they finally checkmated each other. And now both back to their feet. Hawk pressing the advantage. The forearms there, sends the Time Bomb into the ropes, big back pop. And Cody Hawk, the surfer, looks like he's ready to hang 10.
Yeah, Cody Hawk is several times HWA Tag Team Champion. Also held a single, and he gets it there with a power slam and a body press. Cody Hawk comes up
the winner. Ladies and gentlemen, your winner, Cody Hawk!
Over the Human Time Bomb. And right now, Jim, we have some comments about Russ Haas from Victoria.
Russ Haas, we went back from Memphis. We all lived in the same apartment complex. His wife, Deidre, Charlie, the whole gang from MCW. We go way back. He was like a brother to me. He always protected me. Anyways, so funny, and he always had a witty comment after everything you said. He was just never in a bad mood, just a happy-go-lucky guy. And my condolences to the family, and we're gonna really lose a special person. And it's just not gonna be the same without him, so we all love you, Russ.
I only knew Russ Haas for a short time, just the time that he was here in the HWA. The best thing about him was he always lightened up a room. If it was a serious moment, he'd come in, he'd throw a little bit of comedy in there. I don't want to go too long with this because I'm afraid I won't be able to finish, but I would just want to share one memory that I have of Russ, and that was this past Friday night. We were all at the show, and he comes into the locker room, and in his sarcastic manner, he said, "Great show tonight, guys, and make sure you clean up your mess here in the locker room." And you know, I just got a snicker out of everybody that happened to be sitting there. That was the last time I got to talk to him. Russ, I'm gonna miss you. You know, it's not gonna be the same around here without you. Charlie, my thoughts go to you. You know, my prayers. I've been thinking about you guys for, you know, the last 24 hours solid. God bless all of you.
All right, we're back and entering the ring now. You know by the music, it is the A Squad. Dean the Dream, Jet the Jet, with their manager, Super Sports Agent Brock Guffman. Let's go to Haas for the introduction.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a tag team match. Introducing first, hailing from Buffalo, New York, with their manager, Brock Guffman, Chet the Jet, Dean the Dream, the Jablonskis, and their opponents.
Well, Les, we heard at the top of the segment comments from Matt Stryker. Matt Stryker will be in action here along with the excellent young cruiserweight Chad Collier as they take on the A-Squad, Dean the Dream and Chet the Jet and Brock the Croc. You know, the Jablonskis, they've got a tremendous future in this profession, but I don't think they're going to fully realize their potential until they learn to quit listening to that shyster Guffman. Just my opinion, I could be wrong. And here's Haas, and he won't be wrong.
Hailing from Cincinnati, Ohio, Matt Stryker! And his partner, hailing from Liberty, Indiana, Chad Collier!
Collier and Stryker out against the Jablonskis, and of course, Collier, a student of Dean Malenko, which means we should see quite a bit of good chain wrestling. Jimmy?
Well, I'll tell you, Collier and Stryker will run each other a good race as to which one is the better ground wrestler. But you gotta watch out, the Jablonskis have been known to not only stretch a rule, they've been known to bend it into a pretzel. And with Brock Guffman there at ringside, I can only suppose that Collier and Stryker are gonna be in for a long night unless they've got eyes in the back of their head.
Absolutely, Guffman does add another dimension to anybody's match, and you gotta keep an eye on him. Is he an athlete? He is not, but he'll blindside you if given the opportunity.
Oh, Collier, good arm drag there. And takes down Chet the Jet. Now makes the tag to Stryker, and Stryker and Collier, so similar in style and in size, and in just an in-your-face attitude. But now Stryker, he caught that elbow, and now the Jablonskis make the tag.
Dean the Dream comes in and gets met with a drop toe hold, a float over into the headlock by Stryker, and the tag goes to Chad Collier. Both teams tagging well, and of course, Jim, as we both know, that's what keeps you in the battle in a tag match.
Well, that's right. The object is not for a personal gain or single glory. It's for contributing to the team. And two guys, and especially two brothers like the Jablonskis, who can meld together into a good tag team, will take down two excellent singles wrestlers every time.
Absolutely. Right now, Dean Jablonski with the slam. Where's he going here? And goes with a splash. Gets a two count, but Collier kicks out. Jablonski asking the referee to count a little faster, but he's got to have his rhythm. Double arm whip here.
Oh, the Jablonskis, I'll tell you what, these guys, they're so stocky and compact and well-built. And look at that power and explosiveness. And now, wait a minute, lateral press there, count of two, but Stryker was on his man. And Chet the Jet was foiled in that attempt, but Collier is not out of the woods yet. As a matter of fact, he's right straight in the middle of it.
He sure is. He ducks the elbow by Jet.
Whoa.
Jet goes again, and a beautiful spinning DDT by Collier. Makes the tag. Stryker is in. Dropped him with a clothesline. Nails Dean on the outside to kind of set him out of the way. Good leg whip, drop kick, and Stryker on fire, Jim.
Stryker is hitting him from every direction. He is sailing in there, but now wait a minute. Reversal there. Both Jablonskis. Good Lord, it backfired. What a maneuver by Stryker. And now Jablonski on his back. All four men in the ring, and referee Joe Covez is losing control and losing control in a hurry.
Dean the Dream pitched over the top. Collier chases him outside.
Stryker with the arm whip into the corner, met with a boot by Chet Jablonski as he sets up. Whoa! Stryker hooks him. What's he going for?
Looks like he's going to try for the clover leaf, but Jablonski's fighting him every step. Now he's got it. He has got it. He's got it locked in. Go past Chagan. There's a
yes.
He's got it.
He got the submission on Chet the Jet. So with a Texas clover leaf, Stryker and Chad Collier come up your winners over the A squad, Dean and Chet Jablonski, and a great tag match it was. And right now, let's go to a videotape of Dean Jablonski.
Russ Haas and myself, when I first came and met Russ Haas, he was the first man to extend his hand in friendship in this business that, you know, can sometimes be very cutthroat. He was an excellent athlete, and he was an excellent competitor. Russ Haas was a fine gentleman, and he lived a clean life. And my thoughts, my prayers go out to Russ's family, go out to Charlie Haas, Russ's wife. Dean Jablonski doesn't usually wear his religion on his sleeve, but this is not the end for Russ Haas. This is just the beginning for Russ's life with our Lord Jesus Christ. And my thoughts and prayers are with the Haas family today.
All right, we're back and ready for singles action in the ring. Just back from a tour of Japan with Pro Wrestling Noah, BJ Whitmer. Let's go to Haas for the introduction.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a singles match. Introducing first, hailing from Cincinnati, Ohio, BJ Whitmer! And his opponent.
Well, BJ Whitmer now is going to be facing a very different individual. Les, we've seen him many times, but the novelty never wears off, especially when I get one of those free ice cream sandwiches.
There you go.
Maybe an Eskimo pie. One scoop or two. It's the ice cream man, Tony B.
Yes.
Davis Arena is standing for it. Either that or for the free ice cream.
Yes, and of course, the treasurer of OVW, Danny Briley, will be upset again if he doesn't get a piece of the concession action, right?
Oh, as a matter of fact, he'll take out 20% of the ice cream man's time. I think we better go to the introduction before we get in trouble.
Hailing from Dayton, Ohio, he is the ice cream man, Tony B.
Well, one thing I noticed, Tony pitched one of the ice creams over to Julie, who's in charge of the concession stand, so maybe he's back in the good graces.
Actually, I think she's going to resell it at a profit, but right now, all seriousness aside, folks, and believe me, that was not a pun. BJ Whitmer and the Ice Cream Man moving out singles competition. Thank you again for inviting us into your homes tonight and on HWA and And I tell you, we joke about the ice cream man less, but what an athlete this kid is, and how well put together he is. He's got a tremendous upside in professional wrestling.
Yes, he certainly does, and so much energy if it can all be channeled in the proper direction. And of course, his opponent, BJ Whitmer, who said back from his second tour of Pro Wrestling NOAH in Japan.
Look at the ice cream man! Holy mackerel, look at that leapfrog and belly to belly with authority.
Yes, love the way he makes that turn on that leapfrog in midair.
Whoa, he is a whirling dervish. Wait a minute, lateral press, hooked the far leg, couldn't make it stick. But Whitmer's got to be wished he was back in Tokyo.
Yes, Whitmer reversing the whip on him. Ice cream catches the elbow. Whitmer with the more experience of these two, but these are the kind of young athletes that I enjoy seeing coming up through the HWA gym, both of them with a bright future in the industry.
Well, now, wait a minute. Oh, Whitmer. Fisherman suplex with a bridge. I thought he had him, but only a two count. Referee Robert Briscoe says that was definitely only a two, but now Whitmer, not content to let things rest there, he's going to the top. And folks, it's all or nothing here. Nothing.
Nothing is exactly right. He just headbutted the canvas and was stunned himself on that one. His ice cream comes up. Well, let's see which one has got to come up first. And, of course, that's the key to who's going to get back on offense. Ice cream up first. Whitmer makes the charge, caught with a backdrop.
Whoa. Boy, I tell you, that's why they call it high risk. Sometimes it pays off, sometimes it doesn't. And now Whitmer's giving the ice cream man an opening. But wait a minute. Ice cream, belly to belly. He hooked him. He got him. And no.
Oh, so close. Beautiful the way Ice Cream landed on his feet, almost didn't make it, but on that hip lock was able to turn that into the suplex and almost get a pin out of it.
Oh, wait a minute. Ice Cream went for the tip up, but Whitmer scouted it. Stopped short, German suplex. No, couldn't make it stick.
All right, there's a pretty forearm and another one by Whitmer. Staggers the Ice Cream man, Tony B. Trying to stay on his feet, catches Whitmer.
Wow!
Ho, ho!
What power! Ice cream, explosive, he got him! Chuck another one up for the ice cream man, Tony B. He is in good humor tonight, Les, because he is a winner.
Yes, he is. He uses submission, which he calls a banana split. Not sure what he calls the power slam, but it was effective for the three count. He comes up your winner, and we'll be back with more HWA action right after this.
I've got to know Russ and Charlie for the last 5 months, and the pleasure's been all mine. Like he said, he'd always have something funny to say or try to, you know, lift everybody's spirits, or, you know, some of the promos used to cut about one guy being a stockbroker and the other brother being a recycling guy, and that's a shoot, and just all the funny things he'd say, and you know, I just want to wish his wife and Charlie and his family the best. And, you know, I wish everybody could have got to know Russ, you know, like maybe I did, because I got to hang out with him, you know, outside of work. And I don't know. I just, you know, God bless him. And I just wish the best for, you know, Charlie and Russ's wife and his family.
And, of course, the music says it all. One of the fan favorites of young and old, Shark Boys in the ring to do battle with Jamie Noble. Let's go to Haas for the introduction.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a non-title match. Introducing first, hailing from 20,000 leagues under the sea, Shark Boy! And his opponent.
Les, I've got just one question. Does your shark bite?
Yes, he does.
We will find out here in just a few moments, Shark Boy, to take on the ignominious Jamie Noble.
Yes.
West Virginia's own, accompanied by Helena Heavenly, who towers above Jamie Noble by about 3 or 4 inches and probably is tougher, if you want to know the truth about it, than Noble. But Noble is the cruiserweight champion. That's a whole other story, which we will hear after we talk to Haas.
Hailing from West Melbourne, West Virginia, escorted to the ring by Helena Heavenly, he's the HWA Cruiserweight Champion, the Redneck Messiah, Jamie Bunga Noble!
Well, the Redneck Messiah is, so far, doesn't look like he's anxious to leave his corner. Of course, if Helena Heavenly was in my corner, I might not be anxious to leave it either.
Maybe not. You know, I noticed she's dressed always in denim now that she's with Jamie Noble.
Well, yeah, he took her to West Virginia, which ought to be, as a matter of fact, ought to be familiar to Shark Boy, because I've been to West Virginia. And Shark Boy's from 20,000 leagues under the sea. I thought I was 20,000 miles under the bottom of the earth when I was in West Virginia. And I guess he's got Helena over at the trailer park doing the washing.
I guess he does. Shark Boy up with a hammerlock. And you know, Jim, one of the things I'm proud of in the HW, I mean, we've got a lot of fine young talent, but our cruiserweight division, with Noble as the champion and a tough one at that, but with guys like Chad Collier, Shark Boy, Kaz Hayashi, Matt Stryker, Shannon Moore. I mean, we have so much depth and so many good young athletes vying for this title.
That's right. Now Noble press the advantage on Shark Boy, but Shark into the corner, tip up. Noble hits the buckle. Shark Boy with hip toss. Noble scouted him there. Kickoff. Wait a minute. Goes for the clothesline. Shark just that quick with a snap neck breaker. Oh, wait a minute. He's got him rolled up. Couldn't make it stick. I'll tell you, you know, we make mockery of Jamie Noble because it's so easy to do. He is a tough wrestler. He's a fine technician. He's not the biggest dog in the yard, but his mouth, wait a minute, lateral press. Jamie Noble's mouth weighs 300 pounds.
Yes, it does.
And you get so sick and tired of hearing him run it that you like to take shots at him. Noble has held onto that cruiserweight title by hook and crook, another lateral press, and still couldn't put the shark down.
And you know, and when this guy wants to get down and dig on that canvas, Jim, I've likened him to a Chris Benoit put in a hot dryer. Just shrunk down a little
bit. Yeah, somebody washed him on hot. You know, they should have read his label. Helena trying to muster the forces here. But the folks in the Davis Arena more firmly behind Shark Boy than they are the Redneck Messiah.
Yes. Working on that arm, has the wrist lock keyed, and Shark dumps him. But still, look at Shark Boy favoring that arm as Noble comes up, goes right back to it. Of course, there's part of the reason he's hanging on to that title, because when he decides to wrestle Jim, he's got some great ring psychology.
Well, right now, Shark Boy trying to keep Noble off that left arm. Shark throwing the rights to the head. Got his man, wait a minute, reversal there. Noble going for the back drop, but he telegraphed it. Shark, the knee to the head, spelled the end of that. Standing drop kick. Noble, ass over tea kettle. And now Shark Boy, I tell you, he may take this one. Helena's trying to beg and plead for the referee to do something, but wait a minute, Noble finally shoves the shark out of the corner, and the shark again takes the air.
Oh, springboard elbow catches Noble unaware and gets a two at about a half count, but Jamie almost got it there as he didn't anticipate what Shark was up to, and it almost cost him.
Whoa! Noble just ran into that foot, mouth first. I'm surprised Shark didn't lose his foot. But now Shark Boy hooking him up for it. That's his move, but Noble blocked it. Can you believe it? Implant. He's got him covered. Hooks the far leg. He took it.
Yes.
He got it.
Jamie calls it the deadline DDT, and it was very effective to get him to three count as his lady, Helena Heavenly, or AKA Daisy May, rolls in with the title belt.
And, of course, we're going to hear comments from referee Joe Copez on tape, his feelings about Russ Haas. Here we are.
Russ Haas, I've only known you for a few months since you were down here. I had a real good time working with you and stuff like that. You were a rising star in this business along with your brother. My thoughts and prayers go out to you and your family.
Even before I was here and I actually knew Russ, all the stories that had come back to me from other friends that knew Russ were nothing but, you know, good smiles, good times. Every time Russ was around, he had something funny to say or some way to bring everybody's spirits up. And it was, you know, my pleasure just being able to spend these last 4 to 5 months with Russ Haas and his brother Charlie here at the HWA. And, Russ, he's definitely going to be missed by me.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a singles match. Introducing first, hailing from Tokyo, Japan, Kaz Hayashi. And his opponent.
Well, Les, I just got to wonder one thing about Kaz Hayashi. Why is it whenever I talk to him, I see his lips move and then 10 seconds later I hear what he has to say?
That's that subtitle thing, Jim.
We're talking about some great cruiserweights. There's another one in the ring, Shannon Moore. This is going to be a blistering contest. Let's go to Haas and get it underway.
Hailing from Cameron, North Carolina, he is Shannon Moore.
All right, this is usually half-paced action. Both these men have met some of the top cruiserweights over the last couple of years in WCW and in other federations. They're right now facing one another. But as I said, you know, the lineup behind Jamie Noble to get a shot at this title gets deeper and tougher, Jim.
Well, and you know, the thing about the cruiserweight action is it's so fast. And if you don't like one wrestler's style, folks, then just hang around about 3 minutes because it'll change. Because these cruiserweights, they are all over the page. They will take pages from Japanese technicians. They'll take pages from a lucha style in Mexico, from shoot fighting. They'll go all over the place because they're so quick and so sudden. They have to incorporate a variety of different styles to make up for that lack of power, and it works.
Whoa, Shannon turning his back, which is a no-no. But Kaz Hayashi was caught with that clothesline from the back and gives Kaz the heads up on the offense. Right now, get ready to shoot Shannon cross ring.
Whoa!
Kaz dives and nobody home.
Well, now Shannon Moore, a whirling dervish there. Spinning heel kick. Took Hayashi down, now sends his man across the ring. And boy, these guys, if they knew they would, they're setting a blistering pace.
Kaz in trouble now as Shannon Moore goes for that leg whip again. Kaz ducks under and throws one of his own Shannon ducks.
Whoa!
Ho-ho! What you were saying, it's tougher to call these cruiserweights, man. They move faster than you can call it.
Well, I'll tell you what, Hayashi trying to press it, but he only got a two there. But Shannon Moore has got to be dizzy and disoriented. After being knocked for a loop, he was literally cut for a flip by that spin heel kick. And now Hayashi slowing it down now that he's got control, and he's going to more brutal impact, physical punishment type maneuvers like that knife edge chop. And again, and he's just bullying Shannon Moore. And here comes Moore right back at him.
Yes, Moore loops right in, then a forearm, Kaz. And you know, I can't help but notice that Kaz Hayashi, whoa, what do we got here? We got a pin? No.
Whoa.
Kaz, as a single wrestler, has been better, more focused, Jim. That's not to take away from the guys who were his tag team partners, but as you and I both know, some guys are more suited for single action than they are for tag competition.
That's right. You know, it's chocolate and vanilla. It's your preference, and some guys just take naturally to one or the other. Oh, Hayashi, did you see? He went in there with that leg takedown. And now he's got more around the neck. Wasn't going for a pin. I think he's trying to put pressure on that neck and bend it up there in that quarter Nelson type maneuver.
He's got the left arm scissored, and so trying to shut off the windpipe, cut that carotid artery. And if he can do that, of course, that puts Shannon Moore effectively out of business. It will make him obviously pass out.
Oh, but wait a minute. Now he switches to the legs. He's grapevining the legs and goes back to trying to get his forearm around that chin to go for a cross base. It's almost a modified STF. That's a submission hold if Moore cannot get to the ropes. And we might not see any more and more because he's not, wait a minute, he got it, he made it. And not too soon in my estimation, because he was turning red fast.
And there's the only way that he was to get there is Kaz left that arm open, and Shannon was able to reach out enough and pull enough to get to the break. Kaz again trying for the pin, but Shannon Moore hanging tough here, and you talk about a guy wanting to be the number one contender. Moore is proving that every night out.
Well, Shannon Moore's got an extra bullseye on his chest because the kid looks like he's 14 years old. He's just damn cute, Les. And so he has to work that much harder, and he has to fight that much harder. And this kid will take a licking, and he will come right back at you. That face won't be pretty for too long the way he's been getting beat on, but he wants to prove that he's in this sport because he wants to be the best. And now Moore, right up in Hayashi's face, sends him off, drop kick there. Hayashi down and down hard.
Shannon should have tried for the pin there, I think, but he's going to set more Kaz up. But Kaz reverses the whip. This could cost Shannon here. No, Shannon
Whoa.
Up with a double boot. Drops Hayashi, and Shannon going topside.
Oh, well, wait a minute. He didn't have time to execute the maneuver. Hayashi swept his legs out from under him, and now, oh, my God, he's hung him upside down. Shannon Moore's right leg is hung under that top turnbuckle hook. Hayashi trying to slide into home, but he missed. Caught that knee on the turnbuckle. And there goes Moore. My God.
Beautiful.
No,
and
I can't
Kaz
believe it.
Kicks out.
Hayashi out in the nick of time, but Moore just flattened him. Now going behind the head. Up. Looks like he's going for Hurricane Rana, and he got him right on his head. Hayashi's got to be down. No. Can you believe it? His head must be hollow.
So many close pins out of this one, so many reversals out of other moves. Two great athletes, both vying for that quick 3 second, which makes you the winner.
Oh, man. Moore just brought Hayashi down right on his face, and that was it. He scrambled his running lights. There was no way Hayashi was getting up to that one. Shannon Moore, the victor here on HWA.
A very close nip and tuck battle. Both men with several chances at a pin. And Shannon Moore finally pulls it out over Kaz Hayashi. And we'll be back with D'Lo Brown and Ray Steele against Val Venus and Easy Money right after this.
You know, I didn't know Russ that long. I've only been here in HWA about 3 months, and I've known him that long. I've ran into him throughout my years in the business, and every time I saw him, I just saw this light in his eyes. He just wanted to learn more. He wanted to do more. And, And being out of the ring for the last 3 months literally just ate him apart. And all he wanted to do was get back in here and do what he did very well, and that was entertain and compete and have fun. You know, and I was actually at home when I got the news, and my day just stopped. I was completely floored. And my wife and I just sat there for about an hour, 45 minutes, just hoping someone would call and say, was it just a sick kind of joke or something? But unfortunately, it's not. You know, I will miss him, I mean, dearly. And my only regret is not having more time in his life, because he really brightened the time I had with him. So, Russ, I'm going to miss you. My heart, my condolences go out to the whole family, to his wife, to his brother. I'll just miss you dearly, brother. I'll miss you. Miss you. God, I'll miss you.
All right. You heard the comments of D'Lo Brown about Russ Haas. In the ring now, half of our main event, Val Venus and Easy Money. Venus, one half of the HWA Tag Champions, and, of course, Easy Money, the heavyweight title holder. Let's go to Haas for the introduction.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. It is a tag team match. Introducing first, hailing from Las Vegas, Nevada, he's one half of the HWA Tag Team Champions, Val Venus. And from Atlantic City, New Jersey, he's the undisputed HWA Heavyweight Champion, Easy Money.
Boy, Les, I'll tell you, it's almost a dream match. This tag team contest to close the program tonight. Easy Money, the current HWA Heavyweight Champion, and Val Venus, one after the tag champions with Who's Your Daddy, Steve Bradley. Going to be taking on two former HWA Heavyweight Champions in their own right, Ray Steele and D'Lo Brown. And D'Lo just happens to be a WWF superstar as well.
Hailing from Albuquerque, New Mexico, he is Ray Steele. And from Chicago, Illinois, D'Lo Brown.
Well, I'll tell you, this is going to be unbelievable. I thought it would be less. As I said, you got a lot of gold in that ring. You've got a lot of guys who are used to being in the top spot, making the money, holding the championships, and in a pressure situation, you want that kind of experience on your side. Both these teams, very, very solid.
Yeah, this, equal in size, and yeah, all these guys can go to the mat. They can all get in the air, and for their size, move well. So it should be a tremendous contest. Right now, Val Venus opens up with a kick to the midsection and an arm bar and a pump handle.
Well, now Venus, he is cranking up on D'Lo Brown, Easy Money. Oh, wait a minute. Easy Money saying, wait a minute, give him to me, I'll show you how to do it. And now, Easy Money just trying to yank that shoulder right out of the socket of D'Lo Brown. Referee Joe Copez distracted by Ray Steele. Oh, I tell you, Venus working on that arm already. D'Lo, you can see the pain written across his face.
Exactly. D'Lo makes the tag, Ray Steele moves in. Steele, a fine young competitor out of New Mexico, former college football player and UFC-style fighter. Venus with a knee to the midsection, doubles Race up, and he goes to the pump handle on him.
Oh, wait a minute now. They've definitely got a game plan here. They're trying to injure the arm of either Ray Steele or D'Lo Brown or both, and now once again, Easy Money cranking up on Ray Steele. He is really trying to jerk that arm out and over that top cable as well.
Yes, and of course, as you and I both know, too much sameness, and we start calling your shots, man, and you don't want that to happen. You got to keep your plays diversified, and this just like football or basketball, and let's see what they're going for the arm bar. Oh, Steele with a knee. He gets the arm bar on. Wait a minute.
Oh, wait a minute. Easy Money. He saw a hand. He didn't see what it was connected to. And now Easy Money is incapacitating his own partner, yes. Val Venus. And he just won't stop.
Look at here. And then, of course, D'Lo and Steele. Wait a minute. Money's looking, and he sees two guys.
Well, whoa. Yep. If it wasn't D'Lo and it wasn't Race, there was only one other person it could be. Well, this tag team match could fall apart into a singles match between the two partners here. But Ray Steele, meeting in the mines. My God, I heard the hollow sound from here. Count of two, and Val Venus comes out.
D'Lo Brown and Val Venus now, and well, you know, we were saying earlier that some guys just belong in singles and some in tags, and maybe Easy should be going back to singles.
Right now, Val Venus, he is so aggressive and so powerful, so well built and put together, but has such speed. All four of these guys, just tremendous athletes. And now Easy Money, the innovator, the guy with the really fast break offense. He's going to take control here. And D'Lo Brown has suddenly been cut off from the pack, Les, and it's not looking too good for him to get a tag to Ray Steele.
You're absolutely right. Here's a guy, Jim, that you and I have watched grow up in this industry. Came to us in Smoky Mountain back in 95, and has come a long way in that period of time.
And then there's considerably less of him. D'Lo Brown, a chubby young man at 350 pounds, is now a sleek greyhound at 240. But Val Venus is determined to put that greyhound out of his misery. And Val Venus, look at, yeah, Venus is just so intimidating.
Yes.
Look at the expression on his face.
And so methodical. Look at
Wait a minute. D'Lo Brown wasn't going to take that turnbuckle again. Not if Ray Steele had anything to do with it. And now D'Lo, firing up. Got Val Venus back in the corner. Wait a minute, Easy Money taking a page out of the playbook, but D'Lo had that scouted, and Ray Steele is there with a big football kick in the midsection. D'Lo and Steele are opening up.
These guys have taken a page out of some of the 60s and 70s tag team books, Jim.
Well,
and you know what, it works.
They have definitely been doing their homework. And so far, D'Lo Brown and Ray Steele one step ahead of the ball game. Wait a minute.
You gotta see a rowboat.
Make a wish.
I've done this one a few hundred times myself over the years.
Well, right now the ligaments and tendons in the legs of Easy Money and Val Venus being stretched to the breaking point. Oh, Easy Money, and he is especially tender about that area in general, Les. Has something to do with his dating habits. I don't know what. Venus can barely stand. D'Lo fixed that for him, but knocked him down. Steele puts Easy down. And he didn't go down easy.
And right now it's double team time. Joe Copez needs to restore order. The show has got about a minute left on the air, and if somebody's going to come up a winner, it's going to have to be soon.
Well, Copez has lost control of this with all four men in the ring now. I'm not sure he ever had control to begin with. How could you lose what you never had?
There you go.
But Steele, blistering Easy Money. Val Venus and D'Lo Brown over on the far side. D'Lo goes to the sunset flip, so does Steele. Simultaneous sunset flip. Can you believe it? Just that quick, the tide turned.
All right, and we've got about 1 minute. You saw what a great main event on this tribute show, Jim. Four top athletes, one half of the tag champions, two former heavyweight champions, a current heavyweight champion, and you saw a lot of good tag team combinations.
Well, all the HWA wrestlers gave it their heart tonight in spite of the loss of their friend and their comrade. The show must go on. And they sucked it up, and they gave it all to you here tonight. And ladies and gentlemen, we thank you again for joining us on Heartland Wrestling Association, this trying time for us. But the year 2002 is upon us, the holidays. Wait a minute. Val Venus and Easy Money having some trouble here.
Yeah.
I think each is blaming the other. And it may not be a
all
merry
right.
Christmas nor a happy new year here in the HWA for Val and Easy.
And here is a closing tribute to our friend, Russ Haas. Russ, we love you.
When you are with me, I'm free. I'm okay.